us for 5 different locations. So, and actually the event that we have today is the first one. So I'll be talking here on the first one. The second one will be in Sorbonne, and then the third and the fourth in Le Havre on another two different topics, and in Gallery Impressions in Paris for another two different topics. So it's a mixed schedule. First of all, I would like to start with this. It wasn't like originally intended to show this, but because I saw the stare that you have here in the university, for me it's very interesting. So and we have this one project. It's a competition project, so it's not real. This is in Ginza in Tokyo. So the brief was to create an interior project for a t-shirt shop. So it's a very small, it's 12 meters by 12 meters. So one column is only 6 meters by 6 meters. So so structurally, it will look like this. So this is the common approach that people do. That's what we usually do. We show the common approach, and then we show the discourses that behind our thinking. That's the basic one. So but then we ask a question that. Basically, the question is, why does the leveling of architecture has to compete in different layers? Level number one, level two, ground floor, and we try to break there and see to experiment using layers. So this is 6 meters by 6 meters, and then we create a ladder, yeah. And then we create the cabinet for the t-shirt because it's a t-shirt shop. But then, if we do the other way around, this is exactly the same thing. And then we leave the cabinet. They don't cross each other. So you can actually like, and then you cut, re-emphasize the whole thing, and then you have this kind of labyrinth that they are interact with each other. So it's a very different approach to the usual one. And then so. That's the project that we have for the in regards to stairs. Okay, the next one. So I'm starting from the small one first.
Why 6 meters by 6 meters?
No, it was the given brief of the project is like that, because they have like one column that you cannot remove.
Okay.
So just to go very quickly, we started very small, this studio, but and then we expand from 2004-2008, and then we go bankrupt, and then we do again. 2004-2006, and then we go bankrupt, and then we restarted in 2008. But then we create an operation that is, we realize that we cannot make money out of the design, because the clients don't look at the design, they look workshop. So this is the first workshop that we had, 2010. It only lasts for 1 year. We went bankrupt. But yeah, it goes on and off, but we just started another workshop 2 years ago, and it's going quite well, right now. So we already find this distinctive part. And then since 2012, we started the intensive research program. This is the way to us in the bigger projects. So that's why I always start with the small ones. So we have small office everywhere. This is a different cities in Indonesia. So we have this one, and then we went bankrupt, and then I went overseas. I've been working, taking internships in different places with some recommendation from Tadawando, and then to OMA, SOM, but I didn't take the one in SOM at that time, because I still have some problems, financial problems, just to get to New York at that time. So then we restarted, and then we moved to other places. Until 2012, that's when it started to become steady in the office. And then we decided to stay in Bali, and then we that's where we have the workshop at. And then we spent only 2 years to have a main office in Jakarta, but it's right in the middle of the, it's in France, it's like in La Défense, very middle, and we can only afford to buy the address for 1 year, and so it was a big gamble. But we did make it through. And then, yeah, so we start very small. This is the first workshop. This is the first workshop that we invested on carpenters and putting tools. And this was the location of our office in Jakarta that only stayed for 1 year. But it's for us at that stage, the gamble has to be made for us to get into certain states to get a prestigious clients. And then this is my home. So basically we do work everywhere, like the beach and everywhere. So and partners. So and then we start lots of competition. We've done 68 national, international competition. Most of them, almost half of them, is on UIA A level stage. So it's like prestigious one. So we got invited for the Olympic Stadium in Qatar, which won by Zahra did, and this one in Turkey, and this one in both in China. And after that long years, we got into this kind of stage of projects, that multi-million US dollar projects. But it was built in the long road, so since 2004, and multiple times bankrupt. And we start to regain names in the international sceneries among with the other star architects. But of course, we're still very young, so the main goal for us for this kind of tenders is that we will be the one that go into the preliminary second stage, whatever. But the goal is only for us to be there as the youngest. Because it's impossible for us to win those kind of tenders. So we're investing for the future. So this is the tender vehicles that we create. So we have the OSA. This is like some offices in Indonesia. We have the one red one. Then we have the international one. It's called the Asia Alliance for Sustainable Initiative in Architecture. And then this is the research project that we do. This is our lab in Surrey University on urbanism. This one in Hong Kong, Global University. This is specifically for investment projects. And this one in Lehal with the industry. Some of the publications. This is a research proposal in Harvard. but we didn't get this one. But and then the next year we got invited to the MIT, so it's just next door. So anyway, so those are the research, and these are the operations that actually really makes the money. So we invested on those kind of things. We do the projects all the way until it's so we fabricated it from design until the this project is we send 3 containers to Maryland, Washington, and it's a very prestigious location in Maryland. It's the second most valuable plot in the U.S., the whole USA. So the first one is in Hollywood, this one is the second one. It's a banker's house. So this project has a very, very interesting story, because it was supposed to be a retirement house. It's a long story how I got the project. But the main brief was that the owner wants to create he's a very smart owner, and the owner wants to create luxury, but he doesn't want it to be too shiny, because the other neighbor is like very big house and everything. And then so we were talking about the reversal of a carbon print. So when you want to talk about luxury, you talk about materials, where it gets from, and then we have a carbon print. That's the real value, not the how much, not the dollars, not the euro, but the carbon print. So to create luxury, you reverse that. So this one we fabricate from very rare, it's not endangered, but it's a very rare kind of wood in Indonesia. In Papua, it's only grown in one place in Indonesia. It's an iron wood, Merbau. And then we create this, and then we put it at the end of the house. That's a different story. So, and then we sell the whole thing. This is the other projects that I'll go through very, very quickly. This is a maritime project that we did since, we are doing it still, since 2 years ago. It's a very large project that we initiate the project. So it's 600 hectares all together. So it's a 3 different projects. The first one is $12 million, this one. And this is the second one, this is the third one, the fourth one. And in a way, after the workshop, we advance into the other thing, which is to gain a large project, we have to understand banking. So we invest time on learning how the banking goes. So the architect also become the banker. And then we create the proposal that's not only drawing, because once I get to a certain stage, I realize that when the renders and everything is done, at the end of the day, it's the bankers that decide that the project is going on. And they don't even look at the drawings. They look at the numbers. Not the drawings. So, and then we already got the idea of how to do that. So this project that we're running in the past 2 years, it's been very slowly, but it's on progress. So, and this is the other one that we will present. So this is like the contents of the presentation. This is the In one side, this is now the largest project that we are doing. It's a competition for Surya University. It's a campus which built by Professor Yana Surya. So he was a U.S. graduate for master and PhD, and he was working in NASA, and he was in the Education Ministry of Indonesia, and then he retired, and he wants to create a university, which the funding is mostly coming from